Hi everyone, this is Kishore. Today we are going to discuss about DC motors. In DC motor, generally we are learning about what is the construction of DC motor, as well as what is the working principle of DC motor, as well as what is the diagram representation, as well as what is the principle of DC motor. All those things today we are learning, okay. So coming to the working principle, okay, the working principle of DC motor, the input is electrical energy, okay, the electrical energy which is converted to mechanical energy, which is called as working principle of DC motor, okay. So means here the input of the motor is given as electrical supply, as well as the output of the motor, which is comes to the mechanical energy, is called as working principle of DC motor. Okay, working principle of DC motor. Okay, as well as coming to the principle of DC motor. Okay, the principle of DC motor, which is given as Lorentz law. Okay, which is given as Lorentz law. Okay, so Lorentz law means, okay, LORENTZ. Okay, Lorentz law. Okay, so Lorentz law means when our current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, then force exists or are experienced in that conductor. That is called as Lorentz law. Okay, so first of all, so when our current carrying conductor means, so let us consider, first of all, taking as a conductor, the conductor here, taken as a rotor. Okay, so let us consider for the rotor. The rotor which is carrying current is I. The rotor which is carrying current is I. Okay. When our current carrying conductor, okay, placed in a magnetic field. Okay. Let us consider this is like a magnetic field. So magnetic field means here one is North Pole and second one is the South Pole. This is called as magnetic field. Magnetic field or a magnetic pole. Okay. When our current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, then force exists or are experienced in the conductor. Is called as Lorentz law. Okay. So this is called as Lorentz law. Okay. So here, so basically already know that. So these are the generally acts as like a magnetic force. Okay. How generally these two acts as a magnetic force? Whenever the field winding which is wounding on stator pole, okay, this is the stator, this is the rotor, okay. Whenever the field winding which is wounding on the stator poles, okay, at the time here the two ends of the field winding which is short circuited, as well as another two ends of the field winding which is given as a DC supply, okay. Whenever supply is given to the field winding of the stator, okay, then some flux will be existing, okay. Due to that flux, some poles is existing. So that poles is represented. One pole is like a North Pole and another pole is represented like a South Pole. Okay. So this is simply, this representation is called as like a magnet. Okay. So that's why simply you can call it as, this is the magnet. Okay. So this is the representation. Okay. Actual representation. Okay. This is the rotor. Okay. When our current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, then force exists over our experience in that conductor. So that is called as Lorentz law. Okay. So actually here the rotor is, whenever the force is existing in that rotor, okay, whenever the force is existing in the rotor, okay, so then automatically the rotor will be rotating, up to that particular time the rotor which is standstill position, standstill or some constant or some fixed position, okay. Now whenever the force is existing, so here the force is existing with the help of whenever current flowing through the conductor, then force is existing. Whenever the force is existing in that particular rotor, then the rotor will be rotating. Okay. Here, the rotating, which is based on the Fleming left hand rule. Okay. Here, the direction of rotor, which is based on the Fleming left hand rule. Okay. Here, Fleming left hand rule means, so according to the Fleming left hand rule, so already know that, I think. So this is the left hand. So let us take in, I have taken as a left hand. Okay, this is the left hand. Okay, if you are taken to the left hand, so then you can easily represent it to the Fleming left hand rule. Okay, let us consider left hand. Okay, so in that left hand rule, okay, so this is the indication of F. So this is indication of F. Okay, so this F can be represented like this. Okay, this is F. okay, and this is the thumb. Thumb indicates the F, okay, as well as this is the forefinger. This is the forefinger, okay. This forefinger indicates as B, okay. This forefinger indicates as like a B, okay. Here, like this representation. This is B, this is B, as well as and another one is there. So, this is I, another one is I, okay. So, thumb indicates the force of the conductor, or our motion of the conductor, or our rotation of the conductor, okay. B is indicated as magnetic field density. This is B. B is indicated as magnetic field density, as well as I. This is I. I indicates the induced EMF over our current. Here I indicated as a induced EMF over our current. This is called as Fleming left hand rule. Okay. Here these three parameters which is each the perpendicular. Is the perpendicular. Okay. Perpendicular. So, which is by 90 degrees apart, which is by 90 degrees apart, okay. These three parameters, which is 90 degrees apart, okay. Mutually perpendicular to each other, okay. All those parameters, okay. At the same time, here force, whenever the force is existing here, so if you observe this thumb, if you observe the thumb, you can clearly understand, okay. If you observe the thumb, so here the thumb which is lying on like this, anti-clockwise, the thumb which is, if you observe clearly thumb, okay, here thumb is indicated likely anti-clockwise direction, okay, anti-clockwise direction. So that's why the rotation of the rotor which is rotating anti-clockwise direction. The Fleming left hand is says that the direction of the rotor of the motor which is rotating anti-clockwise direction, okay, here according to the Fleming left hand rule, okay. At the same time, so this is called as Lorentz law. This is called as principle of Lorentz law, okay. When our current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, then force exists over our experience in that conductor. This is called as Lorentz law, okay. This is the principle of Lorentz law. Thank you. At the same time, furtherly, so we are going to discuss about what is the construction of DC motor, okay. Thank you.